Hi, I'm Johnny.
And I'm Conley. And I'm 10.
We're the hosts of WDSO's new show,
Explain It to Me Like I'm 10.
Welcome to this week's spooky edition of Explain It to Me Like I'm 10.
Ooh, what's the topic?
Well, it's coming up on Halloween soon, Conley, so I figured we'd talk about that this week. Do you have a costume picked out?
I'm contemplating on a witch or a zombie. I'm not sure.
Going spooky this year, huh?
Yeah.
So, going trick-or-treating, what's your favorite candy?
I like either Airheads or Jolly Ranchers.
Not a big chocolate fan?
No.
Gotta go the sweet route.
Yeah.
So, this week I asked you to think about Halloween and do some research on that. What do you got for me this week?
Yes, I have the origin of Halloween, how it started.
All right.
Okay, let's start. Halloween has evolved from the Celtic holiday of Samhain. On Samhain, Celtic people lit bonfires and wore costumes to scare evil spirits away. Over time, Halloween evolved into a day of activities such as trick-or-treating, carving jack-o'-lanterns, festive gatherings, costumes, and giving out treats. The Celts, who lived 2,000 years ago, mostly in the area that is now Ireland, the United Kingdom, and northern France, celebrated their New Year on November 1st. This day marked the end of the summer and harvest and the beginning of the dark, cold winter, a time of the year that was often associated with human death. Celts believed that on the night before the New Year, the dead came back to the earth. On the night of October 31st, they celebrated Samhain, when it was believed that the ghosts of the dead came back to the earth. Cool fact, 1/4 of all the candy sold in the U.S. is purchased for Halloween. By 43 A.D., the Roman Empire had conquered the majority of Celtic territory. In the course of the 400 years that they ruled the Celtic lands, two festivals of Roman origin were combined with the traditional Celtic celebration of Samhain. The first was Feralia, a day in late October when the Romans traditionally recognized the passing of the dead. The second was a day to honor Pomona, the Roman goddess of fruit and trees. The symbol of Pomona is the apple, and the incorporation of the celebration into Samhain probably explains the tradition of bobbing for apples that is practiced today on Halloween.
So have you ever bobbed for apples?
No, I haven't. I really wanted to, but they're not as common as they were in the past.
Maybe you'll get a chance to do it this year.
I hope so. Maybe I can bob for apples at my house.
Yeah, you can do it with your brother and sister.
Yeah, awesome.
So what else do you got for me?
The celebration of Halloween was extremely limited in colonial New England because of the rigid Protestant belief systems there. Halloween was much more common in Maryland and the southern colonies, as the beliefs and customs of different European ethnic... The celebration of Halloween was extremely limited in colonial New England because of the rigid Protestant belief systems there. Halloween was much more common in Maryland and the southern colonies, as the beliefs and customs of different European ethnic groups and American Indians meshed. A distinct version of Halloween began to emerge. Now we're done with the boring history and can move on to the fun stuff.
Woo!
The history of trick-or-treating is pretty simple. Borrowing from European traditions, Americans began to dress up in costumes and go house to house asking for food or money, a practice that eventually became today's trick-or-treat tradition. Now we're moving on to jack-o'-lanterns. The practice of decorating jack-o'-lanterns originated from Ireland, where turnips and potatoes were acted as early canvases. The name jack-o'-lantern comes from an Irish folk tale about a man called Stingy Jack. According to the story, Stingy Jack invited the devil to have a drink with him. True to his name, Stingy Jack didn't want to pay for his drink. He convinced the devil to turn himself into a coin that Jack could use to buy their drinks. Once the devil did so, Jack decided to keep the money and put it into his pocket with a silver cross, which prevented the devil from changing back into his original form. Have any questions, Johnny?
Did you say that they used to carve turnips before pumpkins?
Yeah, they did. I know, it's pretty weird, and they used to look like creepy baby skulls.
It'd have to be a pretty big turnip.
Yes, they were pretty big turnips.
I think I'll stick to pumpkins.
Yeah, me too.
Are you excited to carve pumpkins this year?
Yes, but I have to think of something more creative. Maybe like a creepy smile.
I'm terrible at carving pumpkins, but it is a lot of fun.
Me too.
What's your favorite part about Halloween?
My favorite part about Halloween is probably how you get candy and you can eat it at the end.
That's probably the best part.
Yeah. Jack decided to keep the money and put it into his pocket with a silver cross, which prevented the devil from changing back into his original form. Jack eventually freed the devil under the condition that he would not bother Jack for 1 year, and that if Jack died, he wouldn't claim his soul. The next year, Jack again tricked the devil into climbing a tree to pick a piece of fruit. While the devil was in the tree, Jack carved a cross into the tree's bark so that the devil could not come down until the devil promised Jack not to bother him for 10 more years. Soon after Jack died, as the legend goes, God would not allow such an unsavory figure into heaven. The devil, upset by the trick Jack had played on him and keeping his word not claim his soul, would not allow Jack into hell. He sent Jack off into the dark night with only a burning coal to light his way. Jack put the coal into a carved turnip and has been roaming earth ever since. The Irish began to refer to this ghostly figure as Jack of the Lantern, and then simply Jack-o'-lantern. They later found out that pumpkins, a native fruit in America, make perfect jack-o'-lanterns.
So did you find any information about how Halloween got its name?
Yes, I did. In the 8th century, Pope Gregory III designated November 1st as a time to honor All Saints. Soon, All Saints' Day incorporated some of the traditions of Samhain. The evening before All Saints' Day was All Hallows' Eve and later Halloween.
All right. And do you know if any other countries celebrate Halloween?
Yes. Other countries, they mostly have the same traditions as America, but in Mexico and other Latin American countries, they celebrate Dia de los Muertos, which is the Day of the Dead. The celebration lasts 3 days from October 31st to November 2nd and is designed to honor the dead. Many families construct an altar in their homes to honor their late family members and make a feast with their favorite dishes for their spirits to enjoy. Food and candy are often made in the shape of skulls and skeletons for the celebration.
They celebrate in that movie Coco, don't they?
Yeah, that's a great movie. So Johnny, how do you celebrate Halloween? And what do you like the best about it?
Well, most years I just watch scary movies and pass out candy to trick-or-treaters, carve pumpkins. That's usually about it. Probably my favorite part is the candy too. And I like seeing everybody's costumes that comes to the door. I also just like watching scary movies. Do you like scary movies?
Kind of. I watch a few.
Do you have a favorite one?
Probably Chucky.
Chucky? Child's Play?
Yes.
That one scares me too much. I don't like creepy little kids.
So, what's your favorite scary movie?
Probably the original Halloween movie from the 70s.
I see.
Well, this has been an entertaining and educational talk this week, Conley.
Yeah, I've learned so much.
Me too. If you have a question that you want Conley to explain it to you like you're 10, email us at wdsofm@gmail.com.
And the sources for today come from history.com and worldpopulationreview.com.
Make sure that you join us next week on Monday at 9 a.m.
and again at 4 p.m. Bye! Thanks for listening!